Hey everybody, so this is Cauliflower Man here. I'm bringing you another video on cryptocurrencies, and today I'm going to talk about how to identify what stage you are in of Bitcoin bubbles. One thing you'll notice about these stages is stage 2 and 3. I use different numbers for like changes in price to identify the stage. These numbers that are in there, they're not exact, and obviously if you watch this video in like 10 to 20 years when Bitcoin is, more, it's not necessary. I don't necessarily know what the price of Bitcoin will be. I think it'll be a lot higher, but anyways, people will understand it a lot more. Those numbers might change, so they might not be, Bitcoin might not be as volatile later on, but they, for the most part, hold true, at least for the beginning of Bitcoin. In the beginning of Bitcoin, it was so volatile, it was unbelievable. I mean, it's less volatile now, but it's still unbelievably volatile. But I want to talk about these different stages of the Bitcoin bubble cycle, because there's a lot of different stages that people don't really understand. And the thing about the bubble cycle, and this goes for basically any form of investment, but the sort of informational and emotional incentives that are created at each stage of the Bitcoin bubble cycle will tell you to do the wrong thing. So I'm going to go over in this video sort of the way you feel, the way everybody in the public feels about Bitcoin, and also what other people who invested in Bitcoin before you, the way they feel about the price. I'm gonna talk about these different angles because they're absolutely vital in determining which stage you are in of the Bitcoin bubble cycle, because it's very hard to tell what stage you're in because everything is telling you're in a different stage. Now, you're usually not off by like you're not when you're in a Bitcoin mania, you don't think you're in stage one where nobody's talking about Bitcoin, but when nobody's talking about Bitcoin, you don't know if Bitcoin's dying, you don't know anything like that. When Bitcoin just simply doubles in price because it was just before nobody was talking about it, at that point, still it's very hard to hear about it. So if Bitcoin doubles in price, you probably won't ever even hear about it. So you'll just miss that. And then a lot of people miss stage three as well, or if they see stage three, they just don't have, the confidence. In stage four, a lot of people will start buying in stage four. Well, you're not going to make much profit there, and you can actually lose a lot of money in stage four. And then stage five, the beginning of the bear market, you'll get crushed in stage five if you start buying there. But stage five is when everybody has heard a lot of good things about Bitcoin, and so you actually feel confident in it. So that's when a lot of people will buy. But again, the first stage, that's just where nobody's talking about Bitcoin. And literally at this point, nobody's talking about Bitcoin whatsoever. And if they try to, like if you talk about Bitcoin publicly, people will, like they'll basically make fun of you. And like I'm not saying they'll actually make fun of you, but the way they talk to you, like they'll almost talk to you like you're an idiot if you talk about investing in Bitcoin. But it's the best time to invest in Bitcoin, but because nobody's talking about it, and anybody who is talking about it gets talked to like they're an idiot, basically nobody actually puts their money in there and actually will purchase Bitcoin. Even myself, as a Bitcoin advocate, I didn't, this last time that Bitcoin really rose in price, it dropped down to like 200 at one point. I didn't buy in at 200. I bought in quite a bit later. I made quite a bit of money on this last time when it rose to 5,000. But I would have bought closer to early stage three. It was after stage two, actually early stage three, probably when I bought in. Stage two is actually still a beautiful time to buy in, though. But stage two is when the Bitcoin price it'll basically double or something like that. Double, triple or so. And at this point, like all the people who bought in at Bitcoin, like they all start talking about it real big. So again, at this time, people still talk to people who invest in Bitcoin like they're idiots. But these people at this point who just bought in have made huge profits. They've either doubled or tripled their money. So those people who are thinking about buying in on Bitcoin, they start to buy in. And this is the beginning of sort of the bull market. And it brings in all these early investors. And then that'll bring about stage three. Now, stage three is when the profits on Bitcoin have gotten so big and so quick and so easy that everybody starts hearing about it. Now, most people still think you're crazy if you're going to invest in Bitcoin at this stage. So most people still don't. And they still wait it off. But stage three is still like you can still make decent money at stage three generally in a Bitcoin bubble. If you look at the price and it's only 10 times higher than what the last low was, the you can still generally make money. If you look at the last low of Bitcoin, it was below $200. I actually think certain exchanges went down to like 167. So let's just use 180, but 10 times 180 is 1800. So if you would have bought Bitcoin at 1800, well, the price went up to $5,000. So you still would have made a lot of money. So you can still make money at stage three, but at stage three is that's when you start thinking, you know, I really shouldn't buy that many more if I'm going to buy much at all. And then stage four, that again, stage four starts because a lot of the investors start thinking, you know, I'm not going to start buying anymore. But now the confidence has occurred for the newcomers, so a lot of newcomers start buying in stage four. The price has gone up, and they hear about all the possibilities that Bitcoin can do, and they're like, yeah, the price of Bitcoin can definitely hit $100,000, and then like they'll believe crazy numbers like that the Bitcoin price can hit. I know recently, what's his name? John McAfee, or whatever his name is, the security dude. I like a lot of the things he says, I guess, but he said the price of Bitcoin could hit like $500,000 in 3 years. It's like, yeah, I don't think so. But a lot of these newcomers, they'll believe things like that because a guy like John McAfee, it's like he's a real smart guy, you know? And so they'll just believe, you know, what he says, and he's a little bit crazy, so he believes what he says. But this is where all the people who bought in earlier, they start to sell off. Like I said earlier, the price of Bitcoin, it went below $200. So imagine if you had, I went earlier. I think I talked about an example where I had $20 invested, or I bought Bitcoin at $20. Well, even if you bought Bitcoin at $200, which was the last low, if it dropped from, you know, it's currently at like $4,000. If it drops from $4,000 to $1,500, you still made 7.5 times profits. So if you sell there, you still made massive profits. So the problem is at this point in the mania is that the early investors realize that even if the price drops by a huge amount, they'll still make massive profits. So, you know, they can see the price drop by, you know, a factor of two, three, or four, and they'll still see more profits over the course of, you know, like 1 year than they usually see with a normal investment over the course of, you know, 10 years. Because doubling your assets, that's massive in the investing world. And a lot of times in Bitcoin, even if you do poorly on a Bitcoin bubble cycle and you buy too late and you sell too early, you can double your assets in a year, and that's just nuts. I'm not saying you're going to do it like if you start investing in Bitcoin, your first year you're going to double assets, but I'm just saying if you stick to it for an entire bubble cycle, there's a good chance that at some point during that bubble cycle you're going to double your assets if you pay attention to what you're doing. And then as long as you're smart during the other parts of the cycle, you can either immediately cash out or you can just sit on it. But you don't have to get the full, you know, 20, 30 times profit increase on the bubble. That's not what you're trying for. All you're trying to do is beat everybody else, or you want to beat the average. And the average is just what the price is. So like if you earn double profits, then you beat the average, you know what I mean? That's all you're trying to do. But anyways, if you then go after this mania stage where the new investors think that the price is going to go to the moon, but the early investors are all selling off because it doesn't matter if the price drops by a large amount, they still made huge money. This is the start of the bear market, and the thing about bear markets in Bitcoin, they last generally a lot longer than bull markets, and so this is where a lot of people just sort of get burned, is that they bought in during the mania, and then they hold on, like their hope lasts for long enough that the bear market has continued, and they've lost, you know, a huge chunk of their money, and they decide, you know what, I'm just going to save what I have left, because now at this point the stages will reset, and it'll be at stage one point where nobody talks about Bitcoin, and everybody who does gets laughed at, because the only people, like, you know, there will be a lot of these people out there who bought during the mania stage and now have lost all that they've all they invested in it, and they're going to say so many terrible things about Bitcoin, and they're going to be very vocal, and so everybody hears this, and so then the stages just reset, and we get back to where nobody's talking about Bitcoin, and it's the perfect time to invest.